Araminta nodded. All right, then. Now I'll show you our room, and you can put your things away before we start. She led the way along the passage and up some scrubbed white steps, which ended in a long passage similar to the one downstairs. She opened the first door on the side opposite the stairhead, and Araminta followed her into a square room, of which a third was occupied by a kind of low shelf running along the wall. On this shelf were three straw palliasses, each made into a bed and covered by a patchwork quilt. There was a chest of drawers with brightly polished handles, a row of wooden pegs, and a washing stand. The top of it was covered by a thick white cloth, upon which stood a basin and ewer, and two brass cans. Under the stand was a wide, shallow bath, painted white inside and brown outside. On a rail beside it hung some coarse, brightly coloured towels. Compared with many which he had seen and occupied, it was a well-furnished room, and it was, like everything else, specklessly clean. But there was no sign of human occupation, and for some reason, looking round at it, Araminta knew a curious sinking of the heart. It wasn't natural to be so tidy. "There's a long drawer and a short one for you," said Nancy in her dead voice. "And unless you've something like a cloak that can't be put away neatly, Mrs. Stancy doesn't like the pegs to be used. We make our own beds and take turns at doing the room. You wash your neck and ears up to the elbow every morning in the basin and take a whole bath on Saturday. That's what the cans are for. I have the first bath, you the second, and Susie the last. There. Now I think I've told you everything. If you'll put on a white apron and cap, we'll go down. There's a lot to do this morning. You can unpack tonight, but you better put your bundle in the drawer out of sight." Her voice took on an even wearier note. "You see, sometimes people come to see Mrs. Stancy's dairy, and then she always shows them our room. Not many places treat the girls so well, and if it happened to be untidy, she would be very cross indeed."